Mga kapamilya, a 32-year-old Filipina has become one of the most controversial moms in America after she posted, well, this photo on her Facebook page that showed her fit body with her three boys around her with the words, "What is your excuse?" posted on top. She says the image was supposed to inspire others to stay healthy, but the picture has gone viral and others have taken offense to it. But fitness has always been an advocacy for Maria Adukayan Kang. Maria, who was born in San Francisco, is the daughter of Caroline Adukayan from Cagayan and the granddaughter of retired Philippine Ambassador George Adukayan Jr. She's a beauty titleist, winning the Mutianang Pilipinas USA in 2003 and the Miss Petite Teen International when she was 17. She's now married to David Kassler, a mother of three and a businesswoman. She owns two residential care homes for the elderly and runs a fitness nonprofit organization. And now we get to see and get to know more face-to-face with this controversial mom here in our studio. Welcome to Balitang America, Maria.
Thank you so much for having me.
Well, Maria, when you posted that photo that made you very, very controversial, you know, people said that you were a bully.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. And then after that, you issued an apology.
Yes.
Why did you do that?
Because I'm not a bully. And that's what my apology was all about. I wanted to tell people that, you know what, I am a working mom, I don't have a lot of time, but however you interpreted that image, that was really what's going on in your own head. You really need to own those thoughts, and that's why I did the apology.
Mm-hmm. But you know, some people, perhaps it's out of frustration.
Yes.
Because they would say, well, no matter how hard they
yes.
try,
mm-hmm.
there are other conditions that would lead to how the body looks like, right?
Uh-huh.
Age is one
yes.
of them,
sure,
race is one mm-hmm. of them,
yeah.
or even probably genetics is one of them.
Sure.
But you know, they were explaining it's not because they are lazy, and perhaps that's how they took the message.
Uh-huh.
What do you say about this?
I think that the majority, I mean, there's definitely some valid excuses out there, but the majority of people who are having these excuses, it's exactly that. They're choosing to be overweight. There's always time to exercise. There's always available foods where you can eat healthy and make those healthier choices. So for those people who are naysayers about their excuses, I would say really look into your lifestyle and really try to make fitness a priority, because it is important and it should be.
Yeah, the goal, of course, is not to have the
no.
six-pack abs
Mm-mm.
that you have
no.
in the picture.
No.
Yeah, but you know, I read that you used to be 30 pounds heavier.
Yeah,
so how did you mm-hmm. get to that kind of figure now?
You know, I was 30 pounds heavier. So the people out there who think that I don't understand where they're coming from, I do. I mean, not only did I give birth 3 years and 3 times in 3 years, but I also was 30 pounds overweight. And the way I lost weight is I set a long-term goal to lose that 30 pounds, but I set that short-term goals just to lose 2 pounds a week. Mm-hmm. And then that required me to exercise every day and to, not every day, but 5 to 6 times a week, and to eat healthy.
That's very, very important. It becomes a part of your lifestyle.
Yeah, my healthy habits.
Yeah,
yes.
You know, but some people say you are a fitness snob, you know, but
yeah.
we also found out that you are really an advocate for
yes.
healthy
uh-huh.
living
mm-hmm.
and a healthy lifestyle. Tell us about this program that you started and that you gave to your employers in your care home facilities.
And you're right.
Or employees.
Yeah, well, you know, you're right. I am a fitness advocate. I started a nonprofit, Fitness Without Borders, in 2007. I started a free mommy group in my area where we meet out in parks in 2009.
Mm-hmm.
And in my own care homes, I mean, I get how it is. I mean, especially my caregivers, they're very busy. You know, we work with the elderly, and I actually created a program for them, which is on my website. It's on mariakane.com, and it's free. There's 9 chapters, but it details all the rules that I gave them about eating and exercise, and they had amazing results.
All right. Okay. Now, I give you the chance, Maria. What is your message to the people who may have taken your good intentions in a different light?
Mm-hmm.
Why should people not have an excuse
mm-hmm.
to have a healthy lifestyle and a healthy living?
You know, for those out there who say that they're a little bit upset about my image, my message
mm-hmm.
to you is, I work with the elderly. I know how it is. And I know that, you know, right now, the most important thing that you own is your body. That's the only vehicle that you're going to that's going to take you through this life. So take care of it and make exercise a priority.
Again, I just want to emphasize, it's not having six packs, because that's not. It's being
no,
healthy,
it's being
right?
Healthy.
That's the focus.
However your body
move it.
Yeah. However your body manifests
yes.
in the process of eating healthy and exercising, it's beautiful. And it does not have to look like mine.
All right. Of course we wish, but you know, it doesn't have to be like that. All right, maraming salamat sa iyo, Maria Kang.
Thank you.
And more power to you.
Thank you.
And to the fitness program that you have been advocating for.
Thank you
very much.